Hello everyone, a warm welcome to yet another interesting session on instrumentation and control in power plant industries. Today's topic is various type of flow meters used in industries. In any industry, we may come across various kind of flow measuring instruments depending upon the application where it is used and the medium, that is the fluid which it is measuring. For example, for conductive flows, we may choose electromagnetic type of flow meters. In another application, we know that ultrasonic flow meters are highly accurate, but if the area is prone to high vibrations, then despite of their high accuracy, we may not choose ultrasonic type of flow meters. Similarly, a vortex type of flow meter may not be suitable for pulsating flow. Thus, to select a most suited flow meter for your process requirement, you must have to have the knowledge of their basic principle, their application, and their limitation. The topic flow meters is very vast and we may have to split our video in various parts. In this video, we will be covering the brief segregation of different kind of flow meters used in industries depending upon their measuring principle. In subsequent video, we will cover each and every type of flow meter in details along with their application and limitation. We all know that a fluid, basically liquid or gas, flows from high pressure to low pressure. So as per fluid mechanics, fluid flow can be defined as the motion of liquid or gas under unbalanced forces. And a device that is used to measure the flow of fluid is called flowmeter. Means it indicates the amount of liquid or gas that passes through a pipeline in a given period of time. Friends, we know that flow is equal to cross-sectional area multiplied by velocity. That is, the flow rate of a fluid is equal to the product of the cross-sectional area of the pipe through which it is flowing and the average velocity of that fluid. This tells us about a direct proportionality between the flow and velocity. If the velocity is increasing, that means the flow is increasing, and vice versa. This principle gives birth to velocity type of flow meters, that is ultrasonic flow meters, electromagnetic flow meters, etc. Also, we know that flow is directly proportional to area. This principle is used in variable area flow meters, that is rotameters, to measure flow. Moreover, as the pressure increases, the velocity decreases. Thus, pressure and velocity are inversely proportional to each other, which implies that flow is also inversely proportional to pressure. This principle is widely used in power plant industry for flow measurement. Some of the examples are DP type flow meters, flow nozzles, etc. Based on the principle which we have discussed briefly, the flow meter can be broadly classified as velocity type flow meters, variable area flow meters, and differential pressure flow meters. There is another important type of flow meters are mass flow meters. So, velocity type flow meters, flow is directly proportional to velocity. Variable area flow meters, flow is directly proportional to area. Flow is inversely proportional to pressure, is used in pressure based flow measurement. And mass flow measurement is directly measurement in terms of mass instead of volumetric flow measurement. So, our first type of flow meters used are velocity type flow meters, that utilizes the direct linear relationship between velocity and flow. Various velocity type flow meters are electromagnetic flow meters, ultrasonic flow meters, turbine flow meters, and vortex flow meters. Electronic flow meters are based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Due to conductive fluid flowing through the pipeline, the induced EMF also varies. This change in induced EMF is calibrated as the fluid flow rate. These are suitable for viscous and slurry. Disadvantages: it is useful only for conductive fluids. Installation and commissioning is complicated. Best thing is no obstruction, no pressure loss, and application wise it is best suited for viscous and slurry. Next type of velocity based flow meters are is ultrasonic flow meter. An ultrasonic flow meter works on Doppler effect, which suggests an increase or decrease in frequency of sound wave as the source or observer moves towards or away from each other. Under no flow condition through the pipe, the frequency of the transmitted sound and the received sound at the receiver are same. However, as the fluid velocity increases, the velocity of the sound wave received at receiver and varies as per the Doppler effect. As the fluid flow faster, the frequency shift increases linearly. Advantages are, again, there is no moving part, no additional pressure drop, no obstructed flow, and these are highly accurate. Disadvantages are only that these are expensive as compared to others, and dirt can impact their performance. Next type of flow meters are turbine flow meters, which uses the mechanical energy of the liquid to rotate a rotor. A rotor is basically placed here in the center of the turbine flow meter. The fluid flowing through this turbine flow meter exerts pressure on this rotor. This rotor rotates. So it uses the mechanical energy of liquid to rotate a rotor within the flow stream. The rotational speed is directly proportional to the velocity of the fluid traveling through the meter. This rotation per minute is measured using proximity sensor, basically non-contact type proximity sensor, which gives the indication of the fluid velocity, which is further calibrated to provide flow rate. Next important type of flow meters are vortex flow meters, which uses a obstruction placed in the fluid flow path to generate vortices. This shatter bar, basically the obstruction. A detector is installed to measure the vortices generated. This vortex detector is placed to measure the vortices generated by this due to the presence of this obstruction. The number of vortices generated are directly proportional to the fluid velocity and thus the fluid flow. Next, these are our velocity type flow meters. Next is variable area flow meter, which is basically rotameter. Rotameters are variable area flow meters used to measure liquid or gas volumetric flow rate as it passes through a tapered tube. Fluid enters through the bottom inlet of the rotameter, which exerts pressure on this float. As the float rises, the cross-sectional area, this tube is tapered, so as the float rises up, this cross-sectional area increases. As the flow is directly proportional to area, the float position is calibrated to give flow indication. The best thing about rotameters are they do not require any external power supply. Rest all type of flow meters need external power source. These are these are not too much costly. They carry good accuracy for low and medium flow rates. Pressure loss is nearly constant and small. And we can use them for corrosive fluids also. Definitely they carry some disadvantages also, that they have to be installed only in vertical position as it works against gravity. And another issue is if the fluid is opaque, the this float may not be visible. Next is differential pressure type of flow meters. Various differential pressure type flow meters works on the Bernoulli's equation. According to Bernoulli's equation, the flow rate is directly proportional to the square root of pressure drop. Basically, it is basic concept is to create the differential pressure in the process line by placing an obstruction. Obstruction could be orifice, flow nozzle, anything. The measured dp is square rooted to give an indication of volumetric flow. Various kind of dp flow meters used are orifice flow meter, venturi flow meter, flow nozzles, pitot tube and annular. Good thing is they are simple in construction, low space requirement and relatively very cheaper. They have disadvantages because obstruction is placed, so definitely pressure drop is there. So poor pressure recovery, not suitable for low pressure application and higher power loss. Next type, all this till now we have discussed our velocity type flow meters, variable area flow meters and differential pressure flow meters. All these flow meters are measuring volumetric flow. The volumetric flow rate varies with temperature and pressure. Thus, additional temperature and pressure compensation is required in case of volumetric flow measurement. Another important type of flow measuring instruments are mass flow meters. They measure direct mass flow, which is independent of temperature and pressure variations. Coriolis mass flow meter and thermal mass flow meters are the examples of our mass flow meters. Coriolis mass flow meter works using the inertia caused by the fluid flowing through the oscillating tubes. Basically, on this right hand side, fluid enters. It goes through these tubes and exits from the left hand side. This fluid which is entering this Coriolis mass flow meter exerts pressure on these tubes and they start vibrating. This vibration is further excited by this exciter coil, and these vibrations are measured by these two measurement sensors. So Coriolis mass flow meter works using the inertia caused by the fluid flowing through the oscillating tubes. This inertia causes the tubes to twist in proportion with the mass flow rate, and this twisting is measured with sensors to generate a linear flow signal. Another type of mass flow meters are thermal mass flow meters. A thermal mass flow meter employs the thermal dispersion principle, whereby the rate of heat absorbed by a fluid flowing in a pipe or duct is directly proportional to its mass flow. Here, one temperature measurement is installed upstream of the heater, and another one is installed downstream of the heater. So we can say one is at lower temperature and one is at higher temperature. We measure the delta T, basically temperature difference across this heater, which tells us about the heat absorbed by the fluid, which in turn gives the mass flow indication. So in this video we discussed about various type of flow meters, their principles of operation. In our subsequent videos, each and every type of flow meter will be discussed in details along with their particular application area and their limitation. Thanks for being with me. Meet you in our next session. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.